Star, fighting out of Los Angeles, California, USA, by way of Ohio, introducing the Maverick, Logan Paul!
Yeah. Yeah. I mean, where the fuck should I really even start? I got hoes that I'm keeping in the dark. I got my niggas cross the street living large. Thinking back to the fact that they dead, thought my raps wasn't facts till they sat with the bars. I got two phones, one need a charge.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, making his way to the dais, please welcome the United Kingdom's number one YouTube and social media star, fighting out of Watford, England. He's known as the Nightmare, KSI! And now, ladies and gentlemen, the president of Matchroom Boxing USA, Mr. Eddie Hearn.
Thanks, David, and thank you, Logan and KSI. The difference between this press conference, of course, no public this time, so no Bibles, no contraception, no Vaseline flying through my head. And it's been an incredible build-up. I've got to say, I've learned so much in the build-up to this fight. I've been promoting boxing for over 10 years. I've been around the sport for 30 years. I've never seen anything like this before. The numbers that I've seen in the build-up to this fight, the pre-registration numbers that I'm seeing on DAZN, who are exclusively streaming this fight across the US and all their territories on Sky Sports in the UK on FightHype.com, is unbelievable. Countries that I didn't even know knew about the sport of boxing tuning in to watch this extravaganza. And I want to thank particularly the fighters and their teams for the access that they've given us, because even some of the most traditional boxing journalists, I look particularly at the corner of Mike Coppinger and Lance Pugmire, were just debating with me who's going to win this fight on Saturday night. And I think that's the intrigue. Two guys that are not professional boxers, but two guys that have dedicated their recent lives to the sport of boxing, stepping out in front of thousands at the Staples Center and millions around the world to have a fight. I've said it before, people might be getting bored of it, but no head guards, 10-ounce gloves. This is for real. That's turned into a meme in itself.
Yeah.
But this is for real. And the impact that it's going to have on their career is a great one. And we thank everybody for embracing it, because on Saturday night, as a boxing fan, we have the opportunity for a new audience to witness our sport. Not just these two guys, but world championship boxing on the undercard. Devin Haney, Billy Joe Saunders, some of the best fighters in the world. And we hope that the new audience, millions watching this particular stream, fall in love with the sport that I fell in love with, fall in love with the sport that these guys have fallen in love with as well. And that's very important to us. And I can't wait for Saturday night. I have no idea what's going to happen. And today we get a chance to do a proper press conference for the media and ask some proper questions. And before we do that, I don't know if you watched the press conference in London with True Geordie, but Joe Markowski, the vice president of DAZN, and Adam Smith got up to talk. It was the shortest speech I've ever heard from any broadcaster. It lasted about 2 seconds each. So they got a chance to do it for real this time and talk about their experiences and their excitement ahead of Saturday. Firstly, the head of boxing. Actually, we're going to go to the vice president from DAZN, Joe Markowski.
Thanks, Eddie. Logan, JJ, I think I speak for all of the Zone when we say that we've really enjoyed getting to know you guys and your teams over the last couple of months. You've taught us a hell of a lot about the world that you guys live in, and we really appreciate the support and looking forward to a fantastic night on Saturday, so thank you. I'll start by saying that I'm continually amazed by the engagement and the audiences that these guys drive. It is a completely new world for the Zone, it's a completely new world for many of us in the room. And I think the audiences we've seen, both online, live at press conferences on either side of the pond, really speak to that, and it's going to be a fantastic event. I'm getting texts from all corners of the world, people saying, can you get my kids a shout out video? Thank you both for doing that. I'm slightly distracted right now. But listen, we've been banging the drum this fall. It's fight season on the Zone. Triple G, Canelo, Kovalev, Ruiz, Joshua. Our schedule has been completely packed, but this Saturday is something entirely different. The fight is being covered by all mainstream media outlets, Eddie mentioned, ESPN, CNN, Entertainment Tonight. Eddie and I speak with the New York Times this afternoon. I'm not saying that all the coverage from many of you in the room will be positive, especially the hardcore boxing fans, but it's coverage nonetheless, and that speaks to this fight, this event, this promotion cutting through. And as someone who spent the last year in the US trying to make that happen, that is not an easy thing to do, so we truly appreciate that, and it speaks to the quality of the promotion across the board. To these men, Logan and KSI, they truly know how to generate interest. Our social media numbers, our early subscriber numbers are tracking to be extremely, extremely positive. We welcome all fans in LA, all members of the media, for what's sure to be a fantastic event. So last message from me, if you're in the US, if you're in any of our territories, download the Zone, enjoy the fight, and open your hearts to what's sure to be a fantastic event on Saturday night. Thanks very much.
Thank you, Joe. And from the UK side, the head of boxing at Sky Sports, Adam Smith.
I think Joe said it all. Embrace. Changing times in the world. And I think that's what's important here. Fantastic that we had the likes of Billy Joe Saunders and Devin Haney and the great fighters, the great world champions who are on this card. And it's a wonderful opportunity for a new demographic, a young audience to come and see the greatness about boxing and why these guys love boxing, why they've chosen boxing and nothing else. I had an interview with the Financial Times yesterday. That's never happened in 25 years on Sky Sports. So it is really cutting through. It's incredible. My kids know about it. They told me about KSI about a year and a half ago. I've had such fun getting to know Logan, going to his house, going to get to know JJ and being invited into his gym with Vidal. They've been absolutely fantastic entertainers. Now they want to fight and we cannot wait. We're working with Joe Weller, with Ethan Payne, with Gibb. It's great. It's a whole new world. Let's have fun with this. Let's enjoy it. It's a magnificent night on Saturday. Guys, it's over to you.
Thank you, Adam. I was going to ask the guys questions from their stalls, but I want them actually to come up and say a few words. Firstly, the trainers of the two fighters. And one thing that's fascinated me in the build-up to this fight is how close these guys have been to their teams and how much the teams want to win as well. Of course, KSI very close with Vidal Riley, who's a pro fighter himself, and Shannon Nakannan, who's been really quiet in the build-up to this fight so far, wants his guy to win as well. There's a lot of credibility on the line for him. So firstly, we want to welcome up to the dais, two-time heavyweight champion of the world, Shannon Nakannan Briggs.
Okay, what's up, guys? Let's go, champ. Happy to be here. Of course, you know you're going to hear that. It's great. Like the guys said, this is great for boxing. This is going to, for years to come, introduce new boxing fans to the sport. Something I've my mouth has been watering over this for years now, and it's coming true, and I'm happy to be a part of it. Been connected through Logan from a friend I met 25 years ago walking down the street. And here we are today, Paolo Moreno, there he is in the crowd. Let's go, champ. Thanks to Paolo, you know, we became friends and here I am now training one of the biggest internet stars in the world. And thanks to KSI, he has the opportunity now to embrace on a boxing career that would do a lot for him as a man and his maturity and bring redemption to some things that in his life that he's made mistakes in. So this is a great opportunity, and we thank KSI for this. And we're looking forward to, I'm looking forward to, and I think the management team and Logan himself is looking forward to Logan becoming future champion in the years to come. And people have said, champ, what are you talking about, Shannon, you crazy? And I'm not hyping it up, and I'm not making it up. I'll say it here, I'll say it again. This man has ability, he has reflexes, He has legs, he has everything, and he's white. You know what I'm saying? So with that being said, he's gonna be the greatest thing to ever touch. Because I'm, you know what? He can't be hit. He got jab, he got everything it takes to be a future champion. I know, because I did it myself and I did it twice. I thank KSI for coming to bring in Logan, which in turn brought me. But you're not prepared for this, champ. Real honestly, this is something that you took. This was YouTube for you before, but now this is the pro ranks, and you came to this war with a butter knife as a trainer. You feel what I'm saying? You got nothing going on. He got 3 pro fights, if that. I don't even know. What are you going to teach you? He your age. What are you going to teach you? What experience does he have? What are you going to show? Y'all 2 friends playing around in the gym. Playing around, but guess what he did? He brought in a general. Somebody is savage. This is war. We're gonna hurt you. You're gonna get beat up really bad. I told Logan, if you don't put this man in a hospital, something wrong. Let's go, champ.
Okay, we're gonna go over to the KSI training team, a guy who, as Shannon said, has had 3 fights as a professional, very close to KSI, ladies and gentlemen, Vidal Riley.
The butter knife. The butter knife.
Hi, happy to be here. It's a mad opportunity, really, because I've been part of this whole YouTube boxing thing from the beginning, from when JJ boxed Joe Weller in Copper Box in London, when no one cared about it, no one wanted to get involved, and it's grown to the point where we've got the likes of Eddie Hearn, The Zone, Sky Sports involved. And it's a privilege to be here. You know, there's a lot of bands going on between me and Shannon, but people 50, I don't care about anyway. And, you know, I'm just excited. I'm really excited. We prepared hard for this fight. We've done things that we never usually go through. You know, we pulled out sides of JJ that he's never had to use before. And that's what's going to win in the fight. People want to talk about the jab and reach and, oh, he's got pecs and he's got a 6-pack. It doesn't matter. What matters is up here. This has been trained to kill. And now his body will perform it. Yeah, I haven't really got much to say, man. I'm just ready to fight. When it comes to fight week, I haven't got much words. I just smile, enjoy the moment, let him go to war. And Logan, I wish you luck, because you will need it. And I'm going to do my part as a trainer to make sure he does as much damage to you as possible. And Shannon, once you finish this event, you can go back to taking your drugs and having no contest.
There you go, man. Nice. Disrespectful. Nice. You're not ready for this, because if I break your fucking jaw right now, you can't do nothing about it. Remember that. Remember that. If I break your jaw, you can't do nothing about it. Remember that. You're a little boy to me.
I'm not scared.
Remember that.
Okay. You're a little boy to me.
And I'll treat you like that.
You're a little boy to me.
This is the pros. They chumps from YouTube. You ready for war, champ? They not. Talk to them.
The one side.
Talk to them, champ.
The local guy, I guess, the Maverick.
Yeah.
Logan Paul.
I'm not a fan of the open format. I think I've said everything I need to say. Is there any questions anyone wants to ask me, perhaps? Lead me off into something. No, not a single fucking question. Where?
How you feeling, champ?
Hey, this is the best day of my life. This is the best day of my life. And tomorrow will also be the best day of my life. And Saturday, most importantly, will be the best day of my life.
What are the odds it goes the distance?
You know, I've thought about that. JJ's got a big heart. The kid works hard, we know that. He's got a big ego, and a big ego is gonna be his biggest asset in this fight. I think he's gonna get hit in the head a dangerous amount of times. I think he's gonna suffer some severe health repercussions. I'm surprised your manager let you do this. Is Liam here?
He is.
Where's he at? Liam, this is a bit dangerous. I'm surprised you are willing to risk the health and wellness of your fighter for a 10% commission. I think you know very well this is very dangerous for him. I think people are underestimating the year that I've been training Well, this man was on tour making music, and I think he's actually about to drop a song tomorrow, yeah?
I've already released it.
Okay, with Rick Ross, right?
And
so, so what are you focused on?
NSX.
So what are you focused on?
Are you
making music?
I can multitask.
Are you fighting? You can't.
Yes, I can.
No, you can't, and you'll find that out.
Oh,
when
you'll
your focus
see.
Has been distracted by releasing music, just like you went on tour, and I'm hitting you in the face repeatedly.
Hey guys, why don't we try asking Logan a boxing question? Let's try that. Let's see how much he knows about boxing.
Sucks, by the way.
Real quick, okay, Muhammad Ali is your guy, right?
As in, like, what, like, do I know him?
No. As in, like, you look up to him.
Are you gonna quiz me on boxing?
Well, okay, let's
go. So this
go.
Is boxing trivia.
No,
and
go.
Is this why you're gonna beat me in the
so
fight?
So, do you know who Muhammad Ali fought? Do you know,
like, in general?
Three people.
I don't want to play this game with you.
Okay, there we go.
Well, also, how does this decide
you don't know
who's
anything
better boxer
when it comes to boxing?
You don't know anything when it comes to anything.
You don't.
You strike me as a dumb person. Do you know what
you
decapitate
didn't
means?
My question.
Decapitate.
Talk
four
to
syllables.
Me about
define
boxing.
Decapitate.
Let's talk about boxing.
Do a simple arithmetic for
me. What are you going to do when
what
I get rid of your jab?
What is 7 times 8?
What are you gonna do
what is seven
when
times
I get
eight?
Rid of your hook cross?
Do you want me to tell you my game plan? Because that would be
why
silly of me.
Why is your body
me.
Always open?
That would be silly of me. Does anyone else have questions besides
he's,
the guy
he's
I'm
not
fighting?
Answering any of this.
Why would I tell
we're
you my
a,
game
we're
plan?
We're
the
a
guy.
Boxing match. Okay, then answer the Muhammad Ali question.
Why? I don't want to play this game.
Because you don't know anything.
I'll answer the Muhammad Ali question.
George Foreman.
If you tell me what 7 times 8 is.
He can't do math!
You can't do math!
I can't do it, bro.
It's 56!
Oh, sorry, man.
It's 56.
Okay, come on.
Fucking dumbass.
Great.
You're stupid!
Wow. We're gonna go to questions from the floor shortly, anyway.
There's no arithmetic.
We're gonna welcome up the UK side of this fight, ladies and gentlemen, to the dais, KSI.
Yo, what's up, it's your boy. All right, so obviously with this camp, it was one of the toughest things I've ever done in my life. I've said this a few times in a few interviews. This camp has pushed me to the edge, to point where I had blood, sweat, and tears. I've never worked so hard in my life. I've never worked so hard training in my life. That's why I keep saying mentally I've reached a new level, because I truly have. I've reached a point where I'm not afraid to get hit. I'm not afraid to get punched in the face or, you know, take a big body shot.
That's good. That's really good.
I'm ready to fuck you up.
I hope so. I really do hope so.
I really am. And I know you're afraid to get hit. You're afraid to get hit. You can't punch backwards. You're terrible with pressure.
So this is the game plan?
Oh, I'm just letting you know what's going on.
No, keep going. I like this.
Always open for body shots.
Always.
Your hands don't really know what they're doing, and your footwork—it's weak. It's not. You don't have the speed.
Who came to the?
You've lost the speed.
Who came to the open workout?
You've lost the speed.
Did anyone see this man jumping rope? I don't even want to do it. It's embarrassing.
It's a boxing match.
My footwork.
It's a boxing.
Who
match.
Are you?
Okay.
You're a YouTuber / musician.
Oh, here we go again. Can we talk about boxing now?
Yeah, let's
it's
go back here.
It's a boxing match, so let's talk about boxing.
You're right, you know something.
So,
I'm so proud of you.
Okay, explain. So what do you know about boxing?
Well, I don't understand. What you want me to tell you what I know
no,
about boxing?
What happened in the first
Ask time? Me what 9 times 9 is. It's 81, you fucking morons.
Hey, what happened in the first time? Let's talk about the
I'm
first
glad
fight.
You've done well with the maths, but like, let's see how you do when it comes to actually boxing. You don't know how to box.
We're 2 days away, and trust me, you'll see.
You do not know.
You know what I think JJ has done a good job of?
You're thinking the jab is going to do the exact same thing that I did last time.
Yeah, you think so?
Trust me.
All
right. I'm going to fuck you up.
Okay, I've heard this before.
You're going to be panicking.
You think so?
I know you're already nervous, bro. I know you're nervous. I know the nerves are getting
to you. I wish I felt anxiety.
Yeah,
I wish I
felt nervous.
Yes,
you are.
It would make me feel human.
I know you are.
But unfortunately, you're no longer dealing with a human. You're dealing with an animal.
Okay, cool. Well, I can't wait to kill this animal then. I mean, it's, actually, you know, I'm not going to go there. All right, just bring your boy.
Go there.
Just wait.
Let's see what happens.
I think JJ's done a good job of convincing his fans that he's a good fighter.
Okay.
I don't think you've done a good job of convincing yourself.
Oh, I've convinced myself.
Because I see through this bullshit.
Oh, I'm ready.
And I remember last year.
I'm ready.
All this same shit was said.
Yeah, and I wasn't ready.
All this same shit. Yeah, no shit.
I'll admit. Oh, I wasn't ready.
Why not? Why not? Why not?
I didn't know.
Why weren't you prepared?
You didn't show much. I was prepared.
You weren't prepared because I didn't show much. What kind of championship boxer has that mentality?
Well, I mean,
you were just guessing that you would have been good enough?
I still pretty much beat you. You didn't take
you
the belt.
You still pretty much beat me.
You didn't take
at home. You was at home. You're supposed to win. What happened?
What happened?
You didn't draw. It was your hometown.
Yeah. Well, I remember
all this same shit was said last year. And the first two rounds, I could not believe how much better of a boxer that I was than this man.
Oh, so then what happened?
So this same thing is happening again.
Happened? And then what happened?
And then I had an adrenaline dump, and you had the luckiest fucking day of your life.
No, I didn't.
The luckiest day of your life.
Well, we'll see. We'll see.
Yes, we will.
Yeah, we'll see.
T-minus 48 hours.
I can't wait.
I can literally hear your heart thumping through the microphone.
My heart is very, very low right now.
Your hands are shaking.
Nope. No, they're not.
Your fingers are tiny.
Woo!
Your hands are shaking and your fingers are small.
Okay, well, we'll see.
Cool. Small fingers,
okay.
Big forehead.
Hey, yo, let's have some boxing questions, please.
That's what I'm saying, not one question.
I've got some questions, and then we're going to go to the floor as well. Thank you. KSI, this one for you. Hanging around you the last couple of days,
yes.
I gave you the question yesterday, which was, you really want to win this fight.
I do.
But you also really need to win this fight.
I do.
Because you know that. Of course. When we talk about bragging rights, this is probably on another level to anything I've ever seen before. You really have a lot to lose in this fight on Saturday night.
I do know that. And that's why I put my all into it. That's why I put blood, sweat, and tears into this, making sure I push myself to the limit. And I've come back a beast.
I thought you said you didn't bleed.
What?
I thought you said you didn't bleed. You said that.
Yeah, I don't bleed.
So when you say you put blood, sweat and tears, what do you mean when you say the blood part?
Yeah, internally. Cool.
11 times 11.
Yeah.
It's 121.
Yeah, okay.
Logan.
What am I doing here?
Logan. Good mouth, apparently.
Logan, the first fight, you come out like a train. You did, like you said, you dumped your adrenaline. I've not heard that before, but you definitely did that.
Yeah.
Is it the tank is there this time for six rounds, or do you think that actually you might only need a few rounds to end this fight?
Should it go the distance, we'll be ready. If it doesn't happen in round one, it'll happen in round two. If it doesn't happen in round two, it'll happen in round three. We've been sparring 3 10-minute rounds, 10 3-minute rounds, 4 different partners, knocking them all out. Every single one of them leaves home.
At what pace?
At what pace? Like, how do you measure pace in a boxing match? Like, quick, moderate, intermediate?
Oh my god.
Okay, but no, yeah. I want to know. Like, miles per hour?
Don't worry.
Help me understand the question.
Don't worry.
Help me understand.
That's how much you know about boxing.
Vidal.
Help me understand, what is the unit of measurement for pace in a boxing match? 5 times 5. This one's easy.
25. Okay. Vidal.
Yo, what's up?
Obviously, you were there for the first fight. You saw the first fight. Are you expecting Logan Paul to come out super fast again in this fight and like he did in that first fight?
I expect him to come out better than he did last year. You know, what he's going to do, we'll find out on the night. You know, boxing's a tactical sport, so whatever he comes with, we have an answer for. If he comes out fast, then good for him. If he comes out slow, then good for him. You know, it's for us to make the adjustment. And he'll be more cautious with his stamina this year, because you know he gassed out last year, but there's ways around that, and we've been practicing that, so I'm excited.
For both trainers in this fight, you obviously, you're fighting at the moment with Al Shannon, you've won a world heavyweight title, you both boxed, no head guards, 10 ounce gloves. Do you think that both fighters can take the same kind of punishment this time around with the new 10 ounce gloves and no head guards in place?
Well, that's the thing, you know, when that first bell goes, when they both hit each other, there'll be a moment of realization for sure. But, you know, it's training them how to deal with those nerves and that anxiety when it happens, because they haven't experienced it before. So, you know, we expect them to have a little bit like, oh, okay.
Are you having fun with no headgear? You guys haven't sparred with no headgear?
Let me just finish my question to Eddie.
I'm not going to let you do anything that I want to let you do. Because I don't care about you, because I don't know who you are.
You know what, this week, I can't be us, man. I probably haven't let you.
Are you featured on JJ's song? Good. Are you featured? Are you on it too? Or?
No, I wish I was, but
yeah,
I'm not.
Yeah, I bet you do.
I wish a lot of things. Right? I wish you'd let me speak, but you ain't going to fulfill that. So.
Nah, probably not, bro. Because this is my country, and I'm going to beat the shit out of your fighter.
God bless America.
Facts. True facts. God bless America. God bless America.
Shannon, to you,
brother, yes, brother.
The difference this time around with no head guards and 10-ounce gloves. You see the first fight, the shots that both guys took.
Yes.
Can't be doing that this time around.
No, not at all. And if you look at the fight, you can see that Logan is a very polished boxer. Thanks to Milton LaCroix, who came in within 3 months, he was able to make him into a sharp boxer. You guys boxing fans, you know. You look at the fight, you can see my guy's got a great jab, phenomenal left hook, a beautiful straight right hand. He's got all the tools. What he didn't have in his game, we put in his game now. He can mix it up, he can slug it out and if he want to, but why would he with a guy, y'all seen the fight. He can't fight. Look what he was doing. Swinging.
How's his inside
you
game?
You feel me? Forget, you can't even fight inside or outside. I know what I'm talking about, champ. I'm keeping it real with you.
You're not even allowed in the ring about inside and outside.
I can't break your spirit.
This guy ain't even allowed to fight.
Why you say that? I'm allowed to fight. I have no problems getting a license. Where? Anywhere in the world. Who told you that? You missing
form because in the world.
You're not from this world.
Okay.
But you're welcome to this world. Now you're going to find out. In this world, we play rough.
Thank you for welcoming.
We're going to beat the shit out of you. Out the ring, let alone in the ring.
Don't talk like that. About the fight. Let them talk about the fight. Don't talk about
and the fight. My boy got the beautiful jab.
You're gonna say sorry.
Yeah, y'all messing with the wrong people. This is a pro division, y'all. This is welcome from YouTube to the pros, man.
You have a mic. You don't need to show us.
You
have a mic. We're gonna mop. Project your voice. You don't need to show.
Don't worry about it. That's how I talk, brother. Don't worry about it. It's coming, champ. Thank you, brother.
Let's go, champ.
Thank you, brother. Let's go, champ. That's an apology, by the way. We broke them, champ.
Let's go, champ.
I told you in camp.
This is what you're
breaking people's will.
Yeah.
They just broke their will, champ.
That's his shit.
Look at him. Look, they broke in chains. They broke in chains. This is going to be a piece of cake. He's not ready. As I was saying, let me just finish saying this. My guy's a real boxer. Life. Milton LaCroix, you in the building. Look at him, y'all. He put them hands together with him. The boy got everything it takes. Eddie, for real, you a boxing man. You seen this man fight. You seen him. What could have taught him with his wild caveman style? Nothing. If they try to show him how to fight with the Floyd Mayweather style, and by the way, where's Jeff? They brought Stitch in, but they didn't bring Jeff because it's not that important. They already got the check. Now listen, when they go to do this Mayweather style, they're going to get knocked out. Only Mayweather, because of his shoulders, can put that cup up like that.
Shannon, we're not fighting. We're not fighting.
Where's Jeff, your coach?
He ain't coming to fight night.
Why did he come this whole week?
He's busy.
He's busy. He's too busy to hang out with his fighter during the media week.
He's too busy to hang out with us.
Do you know what he said about you, yeah? Yeah, I'll read it. I have it here, actually.
Right, go for it.
This is on metro.co.uk. did you see this? I think you know what I'm gonna say. I'm quoting Jeff Mayweather, KSI's coach. It was basically a good thing that I was part of the camp because I did have to harness everybody in and make everyone realize that no matter what, he's not a real fighter.
Alright, well.
You know, your coach said that about you.
We'll see on Saturday.
Yes, we will, is he your coach?
I mean, yes.
Then why is he saying you're not a real fighter? Am I missing something, or are you not a real fighter?
Well, I'm a real fighter.
Not according to your own coach, who trains with you every day for the past month.
Shannon, clear your mind, man. Stop making this.
And you know what else I heard? And Vidal said it. When y'all spar, you know he tries to beat you up? So he doesn't get beat by that YouTube guy? Get beat by that YouTube guy?
It's boxing.
No one on your own team is taking you seriously.
You're paying him, KSI. You're paying him. Of course he ain't gonna beat you up.
Okay.
He ain't teaching you nothing. He's taking your money,
this
bro.
This is an ego thing.
You gonna get hurt Saturday
night,
bro. You gonna get hurt, bro. Real talk. This man's prepared, man. He prepared, Eddie. I'm telling you.
You're
prepared.
You're literally a hype man.
Yeah, with a vicious punch. With a vicious punch. 37 first round knockouts for a reason. I bring something to the game, savagery. That's what I bring, savagery. And that's what we come with Saturday night. Savagery. Savagely Saturday night. I'm gonna be holding him back. Let's go, champ. I'm gonna be holding him back off you.
Jeez.
Yeah. I can't wait.
What do you bring to the sport, Shannon?
Tell him, y'all. What's that, brother?
What do you bring to the sport?
Excuse me, brother?
What do you bring to the sport of boxing? You just told us. He got three fights. He got paid by KSI. You said you're getting savagery.
As a fighter, you getting paid to be your friend trainer, and you got a career. What kind of career is that?
You just answered the question. Why are you whining? Why are you getting angry?
Because I'm serious. It's fight night.
I just asked you. What did you just say?
That's the difference between us Americans. That's why you're coming out with the American flag.
Oh, it's an American thing now.
We savage.
Okay, it's an American
thing. We savages, champ. That's what we are. We savage. Right, we go okay, hard. Right. And that's why we come
everyone
from.
In the country.
We're going to treat you. We're going to treat you like Americans treat you. Abusive. That's what we do. We abusing y'all. We abusing y'all
while y'all
here. We abusing y'all. Eddie know what this is. Eddie know what this is. Eddie know what this is. Warfare. This is warfare, champ.
Oh, okay.
Warfare. Yeah, they scared, y'all.
How about Batali?
They scared. Come on, man. I was blessed to fight Batali and make millions of dollars. Come on,
Jeff, go take your belt from me.
Who?
Jeff Mayweather not train your opponent to take your belt.
Hey, I want to talk to KSI. Eddie, do you have any more questions?
No, I'm down for questions.
That's it, just one question for each other. No one has a single question. All right, right here, I like your fedora.
Thank you, man. I'm ringside, I'm the NDL. I just want to know how you got so good at maths.
How I got so good at math?
Yeah.
Unlike my opponent, I have a very, very big brain.
A bunch of college
degrees. Hey, you know you can't wear that bandana in the fight, right?
Yes, I do know that.
Does that scare you? Big target.
Yeah, I am. I'm terrified.
I can see you're still slouching.
Shit.
You're joking, but when you put your hand here, you're shaking.
Not my bandana.
You know what that's called? Deflecting truth with comedy.
Take that bandana off. Take that thing off your head.
I mean, I think you've been doing that the whole time, but, you know, that's just you.
Okay.
All right, guys.
I mean,
no boxing questions.
Any boxing questions from the crowd?
Unreal.
I've got one final question for both of you.
Fuck me.
I got a question.
Yes.
This is a big event, main event, Staples Center. You guys are fighting on the top of a card. You got champion fighters on the card. You guys are making your pro debuts. Do you guys feel a sense of responsibility with this platform you've been given to the sport? And you feel you've earned your place there at the top of the card?
Good question.
Right. Very good question. Do you want to answer it first or should I?
Yeah, go for it.
Okay, well, through training wise, you know, I definitely put myself through it. I know what it's like to be a pro fighter, and it's tough. It's tough training twice, three times a day sometimes, for 6 days, 1 day break, and having the right mindset the whole time. You know, like, I've had times in the camp where, you know, I've told myself, I don't think I can do this. I think this is too much for me. This is too hard. But you know what?
You push through it, because you're a tough guy, and you're a real boxer, but not according to your coach. Go ahead, finish the question.
Either way, yeah. Mentally, I got through it, and I realized I can do this. You know, I am a dog, I am a fighter. You know, I always make sure, no matter what, I defend what is rightfully mine. And this is my legacy. I'm defending my legacy. I'm protecting my legacy. And you're trying to take that away from me.
No, I'm not trying.
You're not going to. You're not going to take that away.
Unfortunately, your legacy ends.
Trust me,
Saturday.
I'm going to break you. Everything I do will have intent. And you will notice that. And you will feel that.
I would hope so.
And you're going to fucking die.
Death?
Best believe.
All
right. Yeah.
Death. Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay. Big man on campus. Look at the cock on this guy. Shit.
Final question, please. Saturday night, how do you win the fight? People talk about Logan Paul early, KSI late. What happens in the ring in front of millions of people on Saturday night?
There are so many ways that this fight could end. I could answer this question and say knockout. I could answer this question and say TKO. I could answer this question and say go the distance. But to be honest, Eddie, it doesn't matter. We're prepared for everything. My conditioning is top notch. If you want to go six rounds, we can go six rounds, but I promise that will not be good for your health. Remember what I said, Liam.
How big is this win in your world, for your career?
This is a personal thing for me. This is a personal thing for me. I definitely want to go out there and secure the victory in violent fashion for my friends, my family, my fans, everyone that's going to be at the Staples Center. But to be honest, Eddie, KSI just happens to be the guy in the ring for me. This is the end of a redemption arc that has changed my life. And so for me, the only demon I'm fighting in that ring is myself. And KSI happens to be the man that's across from me.
KSI, how do you win the fight on Saturday?
Knockout. I'm going to knock him out. I'm going to start fast. I'm going to start fast, real fast. You won't be able to keep up. Deep waters, best believe. My cardio is better than yours. And you know that.
Not according to your coaches.
You know that.
You know they call ours.
I'm going to beat the shit.
You know your coaches call ours.
And you're going to be fast. Finished.
We spoke to Mick Jeff.
Okay, all right, real quick.
We spoke to Jeff, by
the way. Real quick. I know you used to spar with people, and your coach told them to ease off a bit. Mm-hmm. Yeah, but you don't know that.
Where did you get this information?
Oh, you don't know that.
Where did you get this information from?
Anyway.
Was it the same school that taught you math?
Hey, anyway.
Six times six.
Yeah. But anyway, either way.
36.
I'm going to knock him out, and you're going to see. Watch. Just watch, man. Just watch.
Well,
you're fucked, bro. Trust me.
Okay, we've heard it before.
Okay. Saturday night, Staples Center. Download DAZN in the US. Sky Sports box office in the UK. Fight.tv in many territories around the world. I don't know what to expect. It's going to be total madness. And I thank you both, guys. It's been a learning curve. It's been entertaining. And for one last time, before tomorrow's weigh-in outside the Staples Center, we go head-to-head up here. KSI v Logan Paul, Staples Center on Saturday night. Do not miss it. Thank you very much.
Can you lower that camera, please?
Get the fuck out of here. Thank y'all for coming.